Our cities of today are dominated by concrete and steel, but if we built cities out of natural materials or biomimetic materials, we could drastically reshape our skylines and completely change our contribution to the global carbon footprint. If you walk onto any building site in any major city, you're going to see that the structural elements of the building are completely dominated by only two materials, concrete and steel. Concrete or steel, when taken on their own as individual materials, is a larger contributor to the global carbon footprint than the entire worldwide aviation industry. I started off looking at making artificial bone for medical applications, which is a quite obvious thing to do. If you have a bone defect, you might need to repair it. So we were looking at making artificial bone, but I started thinking about the fact that bone essentially was the structural element in our skeletons. And if you look at a building, it also has structural elements. And so I started wildly thinking about what would happen if we built buildings out of bone instead of out of concrete and steel. If you're making the material from scratch, then you can make a bone material element in any shape that you want to incorporate into your structure. Natural materials tend to be composite materials. That is, they tend to be made out of more than one component. So if you take something like an eggshell, something that everyone is very familiar with and probably saw this morning, an eggshell is about 95% of a hard ceramic material, which is calcium carbonate, but it's also got a couple percent of protein in there, and that protein acts as a toughening agent. It makes it such that an egg is relatively difficult to crack, even though it's 95% ceramic. And that's actually one of the interesting things about natural materials from a mechanical perspective, is they tend to be very tough or resistant to fracture. In the lab, what we're trying to do is to make artificial bone or artificial eggshell. So we have all of the components that are present in either the bone or the eggshell. And then what we try to do is to mimic the process by which those things are originally made in order to remake the material. If you're building things out of natural materials, they're going to be aesthetically very different than our modern city skylines full of concrete and steel and glass. So maybe a little bit more organic seeming. Further, there are a lot of recent developments in coatings based on biomimetic principles. So there are paints that imitate the surface of a lotus leaf that is self-cleaning, as in when water droplets get onto it, they roll down the surface and they collect dust and dirt and keep that with it. So you eliminate the need for perpetual window washing. And you can also do things like structural color. So if you look in nature, some of the most amazing colors in nature are things like the really super bright blue of the Morpho butterfly. Some of their color comes about because of the nanostructures in their wings. So they're not colored because of pigments like what you would see in paint. They're colored because of these nanoscale features in the wing itself and how those interact with light. You don't have to keep repainting the building, because if the color is structural instead of pigment-based, it's going to last for a long time and never dull. In order to make a big change like this, there would have to be will, because there would have to be money and effort put into not just the development of these materials and the scaling up of these production processes to be able to produce large quantities of these materials, but also to be able to test them, to know their properties, to work them into the building code. So it's one of those things where, as a society, we sort of have to agree that this is what we want to do, put resources into doing that in order to get to the point where we build things differently within the next couple of decades.